episode of English grammar series. So in this video we are going to learn about types of sentences. For communication actually we want to use sentences in different modes. For example, we have to give statements sometimes. Sometimes we want to ask questions. Sometimes we want to express our emotions and give a command and so on. So the sentences used for these purposes are four types. They are declarative sentences, that's also known as assertive sentences, interrogative sentences, imperative sentences, and exclamatory sentences. So first of all, let us see what is declarative sentence. Declarative sentence, what's another name? Assertive sentence. So that gives a statement. Suppose I am teaching you English grammar. That's a statement, right? I am hungry. For this, he is a good boy. He is not a good boy. I don't want that. So these are statements, either positive or negative. So these statements are known as declarative sentences. So sentence which gives a statement, either positive or negative, that is a declarative sentence. So positive statements are also known as affirmative sentences. Means declarative sentences are divided into, there are two types, affirmative and negative. Affirmative means positive. The positive statement is affirmative. Okay. Next, coming to interrogative sentences. If you ask a question by using a WH word or otherwise an auxiliary word, we say that is a question. That means that is an interrogative sentence. So what is interrogative sentence? Interrogative sentence is a sentence that asks a question. So if we ask a question, that is interrogative sentence. If you give a statement, that is declarative sentence or assertive sentence. And giving a command. Suppose if I say shut the door. Shut the door. There the subject is not seen, no. Subject is not in the sentence. Because the speaker is saying that sentence or giving that information, delivering that information to the person who is in front of him. So he is asking to the person who is in front of him. So you is a subject in the sentence. So sentences which are used to issue a command or make a request, given advice and all, known as imperative sentences. So in imperative sentences, subject we won't mention, but the subject is known. The subject is always you, because the speaker gives the information to the one who is in front of him. So no need of mentioning the subject there. It is always known that the subject is you. Okay, coming finally to the exclamatory sentence. Exclamatory sentences are used to express our strong emotion like surprise, wonder and all. To express our delight, strong emotions. So sometimes we use the exclamatory words also for showing our emotions like hooray, one, oh, alas and all. Suppose we win a match. When we win a match, we will say hooray, we won the match. So after the exclamatory word or otherwise after the sentence, we use an exclamation mark also.
Now let us see what type of sentences are these. Here, they are not working. So this is a statement, right? They are not working. The information is given that they are not doing that work. So this is a statement. So statements are known as declarative sentence. So it is declarative. This is a declarative sentence. Okay, let us see what this is. Are they working? Here it is, they are not working. Here, are they working? It is a question, asking the question that are they doing that or not? Are they doing it? So it's a question. Question always ends with a question word. Sorry, question mark. So from this itself, question mark itself, we can understand that it is a question. And it is started with an auxiliary word. R is the auxiliary word. So it's a question. So what is question? They are called interrogative sentence. Okay, interrogative. Next one, let us see. What a big city it is. Actually, there is a question word. What is a question word? WH question, right? But it ends with an exclamatory mark, exclamation mark. So, what a big city it is. Showing his surprise. It is not a question. It's showing one's surprise. Oh, what a big city is. That means it is a very big city. To show that surprise, this sentence is used here. So it is exclamatory sentence, not a question. Even though there is WH question word, it is not an interrogative sentence. It is exclamatory sentence only. Okay, let us see the next one. Take care of your health is giving an advice, giving command, issuing a command or giving advice. These all are coming into imperative sentence. So take care of your health. Here subject is not there. Okay, the person, the speaker is saying to the person in front of him to take care of his health. So here what is the subject? You is the subject. Okay, so what type of sentence is this? This is an imperative sentence. Hope you got the topic well, and you can take the test and you can confirm yourself. The link is given in the description. Okay, thank you for watching.